Thanks, ZipRecruiter, for sponsoring a portion of this video. When I started my transition into a career in tech, everywhere I turned, on YouTube, blogs, on the news, emphasized that tech jobs were in high demand and companies were having a hard time finding talent.
And demand for computer science graduates continues to outpace supply.
Companies are looking to fill tech positions.
So I expected to get a job fairly quickly. A couple months later, when it was time to apply, the first job application, I was rejected. Second job application, rejected. Third job application, rejected. By the end of the process, I was rejected from over 50 jobs until I finally got 2 offers.
Hey everyone, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm making a video based on this comment by a subscriber where they were wondering, why are tech jobs in demand but also really tough to get? In this video, I'll be talking about why junior level jobs are hard to get, and I'll also be talking about tips that really helped me get my first junior level job. So I do want to say that getting rejected from these tech companies is normal. Like honestly, even after now, like I think I have like 4 years of experience, I still get rejected. Let's normalize getting rejected. Unfortunately, it's totally normal. Let's talk about the first reason, which is competition at the junior level is really tough. When you're looking at entry-level roles, there's so many different types of people that can qualify for, let's say, an entry-level junior developer job. You have people who've just graduated from their CS degree, people who graduated from postbacks, bootcamp grads, self-taught people, even experienced people with 1 to 2 years of experience. And on top of that, companies really prefer mid to senior level folks. I remember when I was applying for certain jobs, I would be getting consistently rejected because they were just looking for someone with at least 1 or 2 years of experience. They weren't looking for me with no years of experience. And that's because with junior level people, you do have to spend time onboarding them. It can take a junior level person several months before they are ready to make significant contributions to the code base or to, you know, just to do their job well. So that's a time commitment on the company's end. And because of that time commitment, they tend to prefer mid to senior level people who can make contributions a little bit faster. So given all these reasons, it's really competitive to get a job at the junior level because there's so many people who qualify for these roles, and there are also not as much demand for junior level people as you would think. Before we hop into the next reason, I do want to thank ZipRecruiter for sponsoring this portion of the video. If you're a business owner looking to hire new candidates, check out ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter is the #1 rated hiring site in the US based on G2 ratings. ZipRecruiter has a lot of features that can be useful to business owners. It has powerful matching technology to find and match the right people with the right jobs, then actively invites them to apply. It also helps you find qualified candidates for a job and sends them to you. So it's easy to review these candidates and invite your top choice to apply to your job, which encourages them to apply faster. ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use dashboard lets you sort, review, and rate your candidates all in one convenient place. Thanks, ZipRecruiter, for sponsoring this portion of the video. So another reason why getting a job at the junior level is really tough, I think this is actually for all the levels. The interview process to get a good tech job is really, really tough. Some people even say that the coding interview process is broken. Let me just explain how it works if you're not familiar with how the interview process works. For me, to be even prepared to do the interview process was a 3 to 6 month endeavor of like rigorously studying different types of interview questions, specifically coding interview questions, studying data structures and algorithms, studying a little bit of system design. There's such a wide range of questions that they can ask you. So you have to really understand these underlying fundamentals. So it's just a really tough process to prepare for. Even with years of experience, you still have to go through a very similar prep process. And the topics you're studying for these roles are things you don't really use a lot day to day at your day job. So on top of that, let's talk about how the interview process is also extremely long and arduous. So when I apply for development roles, this is kind of how the process works. You first do an intro call with the tech recruiter, then they might send you a coding assignment or a HackerRank test. After that, you go through 1 to 2 rounds of phone screens where you're doing a coding interview as well as a behavioral interview. If you make it through that process, then finally you have to go on site or you do a virtual on site where it's 5 to 6 rounds of interviews. So as you can imagine, this is an extremely tough process that's super long. And that's why a lot of people say that the interview process is broken. Not only is it long, it also sometimes tests things that you don't actually use day to day at your job. And you find yourself having to actually study to be qualified to even pass the interview process. Now that we've set expectations about why it's just generally tough to get your first developer job or to get your first job in tech, now let's talk about some tips that really helped me when I was getting my first role. So the first thing that made a huge difference for me, and I did emphasize it in my video where I talk about how I became a software developer without a CS degree and without a bootcamp, the first thing that really helped me was networking. And that's the way I've been able to get most of my jobs. So networking is so important. If you send your application through online, you might hear back, but your resume gets sent into this like pile of like hundreds and hundreds, thousands of people who are like looking for the same exact role. So one of the ways you can stand out is by getting a referral or networking and getting in front of the hiring manager. When I was applying for my first job, thankfully I was at the Recurse Center and they also handled job placement. So they were able to get my resume in front of different hiring managers, which helped me significantly. And I also made sure to reach out to friends of friends, boyfriends of friends, anyone I could reach out to get a referral before applying to a company. And that really helped me a lot. The only interviews I got were because of networking. I don't think I've ever gotten an interview through online application, either networking with someone on LinkedIn or just going through a friend of a friend to get a referral. Those are the only ways I've been able to get a role.
So if you aren't able to make it into the interview stage, I'd encourage you to do your best to network. Go to career fairs, virtual meetups, connect with people on professional social network platforms. Do anything you can do to get in front of a hiring manager. Even if you have to reach out to strangers that you don't know for informational interviews, some people are always happy to do informational interviews with people who are just getting into the industry. Do whatever you can to connect with others who work at the company or a hiring manager.
Another thing that really helped me too was expanding the companies that I applied to. I just assumed I wasn't gonna get into a big company without a CS degree, which is not true. There are some people who can do it, but it is really hard. When you're targeting these big name brand companies that have like a single percent acceptance rate, it just makes it less likely for you to get your role if you're targeting these companies. So what I would advise is looking at local startups or local companies in your area who are looking for junior developers. I also would recommend my people who are non-traditional to apply to apprenticeship programs and apply to programs specifically made for untraditional folks in tech who are coming from bootcamp backgrounds or self-taught backgrounds. I'll leave a couple below. So I think that was another good thing for me because a lot of the companies I did hear back from ended up being like mid to very small startups. Another tip I would advise is to actually change your resume and to improve your resume. My first resume that I was using to send to recruiters, I was told by someone who had experience recruiting that this resume was not what was needed. If you remember one of my videos that I did with Eddie, we talked about using the Google formula for writing a resume, and I'll leave a link to that down below, but that has a ton of helpful tips about how to actually construct your resume to get seen by recruiters. And finally, this tip is extremely generic, but I just think another thing that really helped me, because I usually got filtered out before the actual interview round, to be honest, but when I was getting filtered in the interview round, I was realizing that the biggest challenge I had was because I didn't have a lot of experience doing interviews. So another tip I'd recommend is if your struggle is during the interview process, either you need to just take time off and spend more time doing LeetCode code questions and practicing your coding interviews. I'll leave a link of a program down below that really helped me when I was doing my interview process. Another suggestion is to really do like live coding interviews. If you don't have a friend who can do an interview for you, maybe you can use resources like Pramp.com or Interviewing.io, and those things can really help you get better at interviewing.
Another benefit of doing mock interviews with others was making me feel less nervous, helping me to figure out how to actually walk through a coding question. Another major tip for passing coding interviews is really studying specific patterns. One of the things you'll notice when you're practicing for interviews is that a lot of the same patterns seem to repeat themselves. So studying them from the beginning can really help you on your journey to landing a job.
So there you have it, a couple tips that helped me get my first junior developer role. And yeah, I hope these tips were helpful and I hope you just understand that it actually is tough to get your first developer job. Thank you guys so much for watching this video and I will see you guys next time.